Hello students, today we are going to start new chapter integers. I hope you have completed your whole numbers work, and still if you have any doubt in this chapter whole number, you can message me. Yes, now let us start with integers. Now all of you look at this diagram. Let us start with the smaller circle. The smaller circle also represent the smallest group of numbers. Yes. Now what is written here? Natural numbers. So in your maths, you started your knowledge with natural numbers. Natural numbers start from 1 and they are infinite numbers. Yes. You can't imagine the biggest natural number. Yes. Now in this collection of natural number, if I added 0, okay, in this bag of natural number, what happened? I added 0. This whole collection of numbers, that is natural number plus 0, is called whole numbers, which we have covered in previous chapter. Yes. So now this collection become more bigger. Yes, so we can say that all natural numbers are whole number, but all whole numbers are not natural numbers. Yes, now we have added 0. What else we can add it to this whole group? Now we have added all the negative numbers. Now this collection has become more bigger. Yes, so this last collection, the biggest collection which we get is called as integers. Yes, children. So we started our knowledge with natural numbers. We added 0 to it. The collection becomes whole number. To this whole number, if we add all the negative numbers, that is called integers. Integers can be further divided into two categories. The positive integer and negative integers. Here I have written the examples. Positive integers means all the positive numbers. Negative integers, you can write down the example, any number with minus sign. So minus sign in front of the number shows that it is a negative integer. Children, you have to write down all these points in your register. Before we start our first exercise, you will note down these points in the register. Now let us look at the number line. Now on this number line, previously we have in the whole number we were drawing the number line from 0. 0, 1, 2, 3. This side, that is the right side of the 0, contains all the positive numbers. Yes. So to this number line, if we want to add the negative number, negative numbers are always represented on the left side. So from 0, the first negative number will be minus 1 and minus 2, minus 3. Now as we are moving towards the left side, what we are finding, that number are increasing, but because of this minus sign, the value decreases. Or we can say that this minus 3 is smaller than minus 2. Minus 3 is smaller than minus 1. Or you can say minus 3 is smaller than 0. The negative value also represents some decrease in the value. Okay, so why the need of integers arises? Because there are certain situations where we want to represent decrease, or the value has depleted, or some kind of loss has occurred. Okay, and if we want to represent in mathematical form, we will show it with negative sign. So remember, children, that the bigger the negative number, means bigger the negative number, that is 3 is bigger here, but it will be considered as a smaller integer as compared to 0 or other integers. So what we have concluded now, we have concluded that when we move towards the left side of the 0, the value decreases or we get smaller integers. But when we move towards the right side, the value increases, or you can say that the integers become bigger and bigger. Now for this side, we are all used to. You are, you know, drawing this number line in from your previous classes. But this side is very important. Yes, you should rewind the video and listen to my points again, that as we go towards the left side, what happened to the value of the integer. Yes. Now, again, this point, no smallest and or largest integer we know, don't know. There is no such smallest or largest integer. As we move towards the right side, we will keep on getting the larger and larger number. Yes, so there is no fixed larger number. Or we move towards the left side, we will keep on getting the smaller and smaller number. There is no fixed smaller integer. Now let us look at the another concept. Another concept related to first exercise is absolute value. Now whenever we ask for absolute value of any number, that is, it should be without sign. Consider here, there is any variable, any number. A means any number. If it is with plus sign or there is no sign with it, if we remove the absolute, this is the symbol for absolute. Yes, absolute value, it is also called as modulus. So when we remove these two bars, yes, the two bars means I am finding the absolute value of A. It will be represented as A. Or if there is a negative number between these two bars, what will be the value of this number, of this expression? Again, it will be a positive number. So absolute value of any number means it should be without sign. If there is negative sign, we will remove it. Otherwise, the number will remain same. Here I have given example for this also. Now all of you take out exercise 2.1. Student, we should take out 3.1. Okay. Now in question number 1, write the opposite of the following. Here, you know, question 1 and 2, I am going to discuss it orally. No need to do it in the copy. So, in question number 1, what is the opposite of loss? Loss of 5,000, opposite will be gain. Yes? If somebody says that I am going towards east direction, what is the opposite of east? That is west. Yes, so you should, you know, think about the opposite meaning of these words, which I have also underlined. For instance, if somebody says that I am 200 meter above the sea level, say sea level is this, okay, if the flat level. Now above 200 meter means you are going up, and going up means represent the positive sign. Now opposite of above will be below. Yes, this side, and that will be represented by negative sign. So I already told you that integers help us to express whether the value is decreasing or increasing. Yes, so in maths, we don't use the word above, below, yes, or less number or more number to represent our data with the sign. You can make out that the value is less or more. Yes, with plus and negative sign you can make out. For example, with this 200, if I write down minus 200 meter, so you can make out that yes, this value is below the sea level. And if I write down plus 200, you will say that yes, it is the value above the sea level. So minus plus sign simply help us to locate the number, and there is no need to use these words. Yes. Now let us move on to the second question, where we have to write the appropriate sign. Now here again, so plus and minus sign, meaning we have understood now that the positive means increasing value or the bigger number, whereas negative means, the negative sign means lower value, where some reduction is going on or value is decreasing. Yes, now let us find out where the values are increasing. Okay, where the values are going up, we will write down plus, and where the values are going down, there we will write down minus. So let us take a couple of questions, like depositing 2500. So when you deposit the money, so what will happen to the total amount? It will go up or down? It will go up. So which sign will come here? Plus sign will come here. Yes. And let us take this question. 240 meter below the sea level. Just now I discussed with you, when something is below, what means it is going down. Yes, below means going down, and down is represented by which sign? Minus sign. So this is how you should think about other words, whether the value is going up or down. You should write down in your book here up and down. So up means positive, value going up, positive, value going down, negative. Now let us move on to our question number 3. In this question, pair of numbers are given to us and we have to find out which number is on the right side. See children, when we have drawn this number line, I told you that on the right side of the zero, the numbers are bigger, and on the left side numbers are smaller. Yes, larger, smaller. So for question 3, I am taking third part. For third part, the numbers are minus 3 and minus 5. Now I have drawn this number line. So from 0, first minus 1 will come, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4 and minus 5. So when you draw this number line, the number which is on the right side is going to be the bigger number. Yes, right side, that is this number. So right side, this minus 3 is going to be the bigger number. So here minus 3 should come. Yes, question 3, third part, minus 3 will come. Minus 3 is bigger than minus 5. Why minus 5? Because the which number is to the right of the other on the number line? Right side, we want to find out the right side number, and right side number is represented by bigger value. So here also I have written the hint for it. Right side means bigger value and left side means less value we have to find out. So mention the hints above these questions, and when you are doing the question, draw the number line and accordingly find the solution. Now use these, you know, hints and try to do this question. You no need to draw the number line in every case. It is only for your, you know, self-evaluation you can do it. Otherwise, just express your number in one word. Now question number 5, an important question. Draw a number line and answer the following questions. So I have drawn the number line. Number line should be drawn according to the digits given here. Which integer lie between minus 9 and minus 2? So I have drawn the number line accordingly. I have not represented positive number, only the negative number I have represented. And because it is said that minus 2 and minus 9 should be excluded. Why excluded? Because between is written. Whenever between is given to you, you will not include the given numbers. Okay, so count the number of integers between them. First of all, I have written all the integers between them, and then you can count also. So minus 3, minus 4, minus 5, minus 6, minus 7 and minus 8. It is important to write down the negative sign, otherwise you will lose marks. Now out of this collection, which is the largest? Now as I already told you, larger number is always on the right side. Yes, so on this number line between minus 2 and minus 9, which number is on the right side? Extreme right is minus 3. So this is larger number. Here also I have written. keep this word in your mind. In fact, above this you should write down right. Always right side represent larger number and left side will represent smaller number. And which number is on the extreme left? Minus 8. So minus 8 is the smallest number. Yes, I hope the answer is clear to you. Now let us move on to question number 6. In question number 6, write 4 consecutive integers just greater than minus 9. Children, we have done, we have just now drawn the number line, minus 9. And we are looking for, you know, greater number. Greater number are on the right side. So right side of minus 9, which number will come? Minus 8. And because they are talking about consecutive integer, so we, without skipping any number, we will continuously write down the series. So these are the 4 consecutive number greater than minus 9. Similarly, in the next question, we have to write down 4 consecutive integers just before minus 2. Now, just before minus 2, here before minus 2 means these numbers. Okay, before is the word with used for left side. So left side, these are the following numbers which come. Yes. Now let us move on to the next question. In question number 8, again draw a number line and then answer the following question. For every part, you will draw a separate number line. Yes. I am taking first part and third part. Which number will we reach if we move 6 unit to the right of minus 1? So I have drawn the number line here. From minus 1, I have to take how many jumps? 6 jumps. And to which side? Right side. Look here, my jump is going towards right side. So after taking 6 jump, I went to which integer? Number 5. So here, which number? You will simply write down, number is equal to 5. So children, whatever moves or whatever jumps are given to you, accordingly you make it and try to find out the jump and remember where we are going, towards right or towards left. In the third part, they are saying, in which direction should we move? In which direction means towards right side or towards left side we have to move? Should we move to reach 3 from minus 3? So means you are at present at in the negative zone. You are to in the negative number. Minus 3 is negative. To reach to the positive number, which direction should I take? I should move towards this direction. That is the right side. So other two questions are similar to it. Do it as a homework. Now let us come to question number 9. In question number 9, with using the number line, write the integer which is 5 more than minus 1. We have to write the integer, but for every part you will draw the number line. I am taking third part. Here you can use the hint that when more is given, we will move towards right side, and when less is given, we will move towards left side. So in third part, it is given 7 less than 2. We have to make how many jumps? 7 jumps. And less means towards left side I will make. But you keep these words in your mind, that less means we will take jump towards left side, and right means taking towards when more is given to you. Yes. So try to, you know, link these words in your brain. Keep on recalling the relation between the two words. So 7 less than 2. I will locate 2 on the number line. Yes. 7 jumps I have to make. Less means towards left. L for less, L for left. So 7 jumps I have taken, and to which number I reached? Minus 5. So answer will be minus 5. This is how you will do rest of the part as homework. Now let us take question number 10. In question number 10, I am doing second part. How many integers are there between minus 6 and 3? So what I have done, I have written all the integers from minus 6 to 3. Minus 6, minus 5, 4, 3, 2, 1 and then 0, then 1, 2, 3 again. Yes? And here again, between word is coming. So when between comes, circle the numbers, exclude them. Minus 6 and 3 won't be counted. Just count the numbers in between. Here we have to only count the numbers in between like we have done in another previous question. Question number 5, we have written the numbers. Yes. Now third part, how many whole numbers are between this? Now when it is whole number, in the starting of the lesson, I taught you that whole number starts from 0. Yes. So here we will not count any negative number. This cross means exclude all the negative number. So I am counting from 0. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And between means these numbers will not be included. So 6 is not written because word between is there. Yes. Between means whatever number are given, you will not count them. You will not involve them. So how many numbers in total there are? 6 numbers. That will be your answer. Now let us move on to question number 11. In question 11, we have to evaluate. Now when you look closely, all the numbers are in these bars, which means we have to count the modulus value. We have to count the absolute value. An absolute value is counted by ignoring the sign. So children, here you are going to simply do your addition and subtraction the way you do it. Okay. Here whatever number will come, you will just remove the sign. Here 5 minus 13 will give you minus 8 and you will remove the sign. You will not include negative sign. I am doing here third part. In third part we have absolute value of minus 11 plus 9. So first remove the modulus, these bars to be removed. When you are removing the bar, remove the sign also. Okay. So minus 11, when the bars are removed, will become 11 and plus 9 will remain 9 only. And what is the final answer? 11 plus 9 equals to 20. Yes. In the fourth part here, sorry, in the sixth part, it should be sixth part. Yes. In the sixth part, minus 19 and minus 13 and here subtraction sign here. So when the digit come out of the bar, sign get removed. So this will become 19 and here also minus 13 will become 13 and the sign in between them is minus, that is subtraction will happen and 19 minus 13 is 6. And this is how you will do. So remember children, in whenever you see the bar, how we'll remove the bar? We remove the bar by removing the sign. Yes. So that becomes the absolute value of that. In question number 12, try to do it yourself. We just have to find out which is smaller, which is larger. I have already explained you that the smaller number will be on the left side and larger number will be on the larger number is on the left side. So whatever two numbers are given to you, just check which is on the left side, which is on the right side and then decide the sign. Now let us take 13th question, an important question. Now here the word is written ascending. Ascending means going towards the big number. Yes. We have to take the big number. Now here I have written big negative. Means for ascending case, I will start with the bigger number but with negative sign. Now I am taking the second part in this question. When you look closely, this is the bigger number with negative sign. So this will be considered as the smallest number as per the number line. Yes, we have done this concept in the starting, that the number which is on the more, you know, left side is going to be the smallest number. So minus 33, this is how you will locate. Look for bigger number but negative sign. That makes it a, in total, a smaller number. This together becomes a smaller number, or you can say smallest number. Yes, so a number, a digit which is big but with negative sign, it is called as smallest digit. And next smallest digit is minus 31, next is minus 28. So now we are going towards, you know, right side, that is the bigger number. Minus 28, minus 4, minus 2, and the next digits are 9 and 35. This is how we are approaching towards the bigger number. Yes. Now in the descending case, I am taking the second part for this. For descending case, we will start with the big digit but positive sign. So out of this collection, this is the biggest digit with positive sign. And now keep on writing the numbers which are smaller than this. So number smaller than 95 is 36. And next number smaller than this will be a negative number with sign. Now look here. Carefully write down the negative number. When we are writing negative number, make sure that the smaller number will come first and bigger number will come later. These numbers are smallest. Yes, although the digit is big, but because of this sign, negative sign, this number becomes a smaller number. So when we write down the descending numbers, we write down the with the positive numbers. Look for that if they are present in the questions. So you will write down first big positive number, then next positive number, and then look for the negative number with smaller value first. So smaller value of negative number will come first, and then the larger values will come in the end. And this is how you will arrange the number. So with this, your exercise 3.1 is over, and do the homework as suggested to you. In the next class, we will start with addition of integers. Thank you, children.